This recording is designed to guide you down into a deep, natural state of physical and emotional relaxation. Therefore, never listen to this recording if you're driving or operating machinery. Take some time now to sit or lie down. Make sure you're sitting or lying down in a comfortable position. Take a deep breath in and out. And allow your eyes to close. Allow your eyes to comfortably close, knowing that if you need to, you can open them at any point during this recording. But for the moment, just allow your eyes to remain comfortably closed. And allow the sound of my voice to take you into relaxation. Into deeper levels of relaxation. Let's start the relaxation process by moving through the muscles of the body. As I move through the muscle groups, allow your mind to focus on that area and allow the muscles in that area to relax and loosen and soften. Don't try it, just allow it to happen. Move your awareness to your right hand, the right thumb, the right fingers. Allow your hand and fingers and thumbs to relax. Move your awareness with the relaxation up through the wrist, through the elbow, up the arm relaxing, and into the right shoulder. Move your awareness across your shoulders now, into the left shoulder. Relax that area. Down through the arm. Down through the left elbow. Down through the left wrist. And into the hand, the thumb, the finger. Your shoulders, your arms, your hands, your thumbs, your fingers, relaxed. Allow them to soften. Allow them to relax. Imagine them becoming heavier. Move your awareness to your chest. Relax the muscles in the chest, softening and loosening, and down into the stomach. As you relax and release the muscles in the stomach, become aware of their movement as you breathe in and out. Imagine that each time that you breathe out, the stomach muscles relax a little more. That's right. Move into the hips, into the thighs, into the knees, into the calves. Into the ankles, relaxing. Into the feet. Into the toes. Relax your legs. Notice the heaviness within your legs. and increase it. So from the top of your shoulders, down to your fingertips, down to your toes, the body is relaxing. And you continue to relax now. The sound of my voice will continue to relax you, allowing you to become a little more comfortable, a little more relaxed, a little heavier. You could be curious to find out how relaxed you become during this recording. Be aware also that your mind may wander from time to time. It really doesn't matter where you wander. It doesn't matter what you think of. The suggestions, the affirmations, the words on this recording will still enter, will still change you in a positive, healthy, beneficial manner, no matter where you drift, no matter where you go. In a few moments, to help you deepen the feeling of relaxation, you'll hear me count down from 10 to 1, slowly, rhythmically. With each slow descending number between 10 and 1, allow yourself to become twice as deeply relaxed as you are at the moment. Simply allow it to happen. Notice yourself sinking down with each slow descending number. So ready. Ten. Nine. Deeper and deeper. Eight. Seven. Drifting down. Six. Deeper and deeper relax. Five. Four. Becoming ever deeper. Three. Two. And one. All the way down. Deep down relaxed. Deeper and deeper down relaxed. As you relax, as you continue to relax, comfortably, easily, safely, I want you to know that one of the most beautiful things about relaxation is that in this slow, heavy, comfortable state, you can do anything you wish. You can drift away any place. In fact, in a few moments in time, I'm going to ask you to imagine certain things. Don't try too hard, just be aware of the process. Follow the suggestions. Allow them to become part of you, part of your inner world. Notice the suggestions as they pass through. And the sound of my voice and the positive visualizations, affirmations and words will help you to drift deeper down into relaxation and peace. Now I know that sometime in your life you may have walked in the countryside, in the hills and trees, beside lakes and rivers. Or you may have seen something similar on the television or at the cinema. Or you may have imagined it. Walking by the side of a river, or simply looking at water flowing past you, is so peaceful and soothing. Can you remember a scene like this now? Or can you simply imagine a scene with a river flowing? Now, as I talk, and I can do so comfortably and without worry, you can listen to me comfortably and without worry as I talk about a particular river, about the life of a particular river, one that you do know, one that seems familiar. Now you may know, as I know, that some people and tribes somewhere in the world believe that water and rivers have a spirit, and river spirits have magical properties. And we can call upon the spirit of the river to learn from it and move on. It makes you curious about rivers and streams, does it not? And if rivers have a spirit or a soul like us, they may have a life too. Thinking about that river flowing, relaxing and peacefully, it's odd to think about rivers having a life, is it not? An infant age, a youthful age, a middle age, and a senior age. And you already know what age your river of life is. And you may be wondering, as I am wondering, what we can learn from this river. But to learn from the river, you can imagine that it is like you, a person with emotions and a life of its own. Can you sense that? And you can imagine, like you, the river may be troubled. Troubled by issues that you know and you understand. You know how these things can change your course. These things changed the river's course, and so it became stuck. Stuck by flowing into a swamp, becoming deeper and darker. Darker and silent. Silent and still. And the river could not see a way out. So the river spirit seeking counsel, spoke to its higher spirit, the part that remains hidden and unseen. And the river spirit asked the great high spirit for help and counsel. Now we both know that this great high spirit has resources and knowledge to help. So the great high spirit asked the river spirit to go on a journey in comfort and in peace, and to learn from the journey how to begin to change. Before you make this journey, said the great high spirit, you must accept that only you can take responsibility for your own learnings and resources to change your direction. The high river spirit, in its wisdom, explained to the river that where it is today is because of all its past choices and decisions. Some may not even have been consciously known about. The High Spirit asked, "Do you acknowledge and accept this?" The River Spirit said, "Yes, I accept this. And I am now ready to do whatever I need to do to bring about change." The river spirit felt pleased and empowered and energized to make the changes. Now you can imagine how this feels. So it is time to go on the journey. The High Spirit said, "Come with me and let us all float above your river, the river of life. Float so high above that you can see all the ages of your life and all the way into the future and all the way back to your beginning. Are you there? What do you see? Now let us all float backwards to an early period of your life that troubled you, and float back high above with ease and safety and comfort. And the river spirit noticed the beginnings of its troubles and how they could have influenced the direction of its life. Now, of course, at that time, the younger river did not have the strength or the wisdom or the knowledge or the resources to deal with it. And the High Spirit explained that there is no blame attached to the younger River Spirit. Only a need for resources and to learn what it can from the event so that it can heal, so that it can move on in a different direction. Maybe the younger river needed love and compassion. Perhaps it needed confidence and self-assurance. It may have needed courage and determination. Or maybe it simply needed to see things in a different way. Decide now what resources and learnings you need. Decide now what resources and learnings you need, so that you can let go of all those bad feelings easily and effortlessly. Once you have those resources, ask the Great High Spirit to integrate them with you, to allow them to become part of you, part of your inner truths, part of you, to integrate the learnings into your very being, so that they are always available to you, to use anytime. And sooner or later, after you do this, you can notice, and you can feel, and you are letting your troubles go. You are finding new energy and inspiration, and your mood is lifting. And you must notice now, as I am noticing now, that the river spirit is pleased. The high spirit said, "Now come back along the river of life to the present, high above the river." And as you do, notice other events that have altered your course. Look down on them and learn from each what you need to learn to change your life. And keep the learnings and resources and wisdom in that special place where you keep them, so that they will always be available to you. The river spirit came back to the present, high above the river of life. The high spirit said, "Look down and see where you can make changes. Notice how you feel, and notice how much you are now in control of your future." The river spirit is really pleased. It sees a way forward, knowing that its course has changed and its life has changed. It is no longer trapped in a world of its own making and decides to act. How do you see that? How do you feel now? What changes will you make? How will you act right now? The High Spirit pointed towards the future and asked the River Spirit to look as far into the future as it could see, and even further. The High Spirit asked the River Spirit to notice its course and its quality of life. Notice the changes with the new resources and learnings. Do you notice the changes as you look into the future? Being really pleased, the High Spirit said, "Go back down into your life now and use your resources and learnings wisely as you decide to act now and change with comfort and ease. And the river spirit was also pleased and decided to act and planned to do three things immediately that would begin the change. What three things will you do immediately? As the minutes become hours, and the hours become days, and the days become weeks, changes happen. Sometimes small, sometimes large, and the river spirit frees itself from the swamp, using all of its resources and all of its knowledge and all of its wisdom to lift its mood and become happy and joyous and motivated and free-flowing once more. As we near the end of this recording, your unconscious mind is taking on board all these positive messages. They're becoming part of you, changing the way you think, act, react, and behave in a positive, beneficial manner. Your unconscious mind is deciding in this moment whether to let you consciously remember all, some, or none of these messages. Only your unconscious mind knows what's best for you. Whether to let you remember consciously all, some, or none of these messages. But as the minutes, the hours, the days, and the weeks go by, your unconscious mind, with new resources, abilities, strengths, and skills, is helping you change in a positive, healthy, beneficial manner. That's right. In a few moments, you'll hear me slowly and gently count from 1 to 10, with each slow ascending number between 1 and 10, you start to become a bit more aware and alert and re-energized. At 5, wiggle your fingers and toes. At 8, take a deep breath and gently open your eyes. And at 10, you're fully back, rested and refreshed and relaxed, re-energized, bringing back a sense of achievement, of change, and a lovely, deep and long-lasting sense of well-being all over. A long-lasting sense of change and well-being. So at 5, wiggle fingers and toes. At 8, a deep breath and gently open your eyes. And at 10, fully back. So ready. 1, 2, 3, coming back up. 4, 5, waking up, fingers and toes. 6, 7, 8, gently open your eyes, take a deep breath. 9, 10, fully awake, fully aware, fully back. Have a nice, gentle stretch and relax.